Some people call me the space cowboy. Yeah. Some call me the gangster of love. Some people call me Maurice.
Hey, 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 what's going on out there, fellow Tightwads, fellow Cal football fans, fellow Cal athletics fans, and of course, fellow A's fans who are, of course, watching the first of two shows going down today, the final doubleheader of TBR and AFR going down on this Sunday in December. Show one of the doubleheader leading things off here, of course, on twitch.tv/A's Fan Radio. It is, of course, the 39th edition of the Bear Raid. Presented by Tightwad Hill. Good afternoon, a wet afternoon out here in the East Bay to all of you tuning in from Berkeley, Oakland, and beyond. It is 30th and current sitting governor of Tightwad, Keith Salminen, coming at you, of course, from the broadcasting HQ of the Bear Raid and A's Fan Radio, Dub 6 Studios, located in the Diamond District of Oakland, California. Man, busy weekend for yours truly. Had a long, busy day yesterday doing things with Forever Oakland as we had yet another successful toy drive, giving away toys to over 400 children. So great job by Forever Oakland and all of our sponsors out there helping out, holding down the fort, of course, at Mob Alley while they were out doing that. Had, of course, the watch party for the Indy Bowl going down. We'll, of course, talk about that before we recap things with the game. And, of course, also we got some Cal basketball action to talk on deck because pretty much between now and the end of the year, it's just basketball going down at the University of California. We are live. First time in a while that the whole show will actually be live. And first time in a while that I will not be hosting an entire show solo and live, as of course the other half of what has become now known as the Govs is here with me today on this edition of the Bear Raid. 29th governor of Tightwad, Taddy, joining us here at the studio. Tad, my man, good to always have you here.
It's
as always, how you doing?
I'm doing swell for real this Christmas, and I wish everyone have yourself a merry little Christmas, and that's all I'm gonna say.
Merry Christmas, happy holidays to all of our fellow Cal fans.
Have a great one.
Out there in Bear territory. Obviously, got a decent amount of stuff to throw y'all's way this afternoon before we wrap things up, take a break, and then, of course, turn things over later on in the evening to our sister podcast that, of course, will be doing their final show at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Got, of course, Cal football on deck to obviously touch bases on with the bowl game going on yesterday. And, of course, as mentioned, we got Cal basketball on both the men's and women's side as well. And one sport to actually preview that for yours truly, unless the Oakland Ballers hint end up hiring me. And again, thanks to all of you out there that are hitting up the Ballers and encouraging them to hire this crazy mofo as a potential addition to the radio play-by-play team over there. Unless that happens, the thing that we'll be touching bases on during the final segment might end up being the only baseball yours truly talks about for a while, since at this point, fuck the A's after shit tonight with A's Fan Radio. But that's, of course, for later on tonight. This is the Cal Podcast right now. Anyway. On that note, let's go ahead and get this afternoon's portion of the Cal football segment underway. Before we, of course, get into the shindigs and whatnot of last night's Radiance Assurance Independence Bowl, just like with the previous game to end the regular season for Cal football, we, of course, all made our way down to a frequent watering hole of Cal fans since 1922 on the Oakland-Berkeley border. It's just changed locations since it initially opened in 1922, that, of course, being yet another Tightwad watch party at the Kingfish, located on Telegraph, just a little north of the Temescal District in Oakland, California. Always been a great spot to hang out to watch either Cal football or any of the other Cal athletics programs over the years. Places covered with Cal memorabilia and whatnot in there. We actually were looking at some photos in there of some of the old quarterbacks trying to figure out who was who at one point when we initially first met up for the game. Of course, myself, Taddy, Donnie Knucklehead, who unfortunately was unable to join us for today's show because we already had prior plans for a 49er watch party, Duncan and the Rally Chicken, all there, of course, but there were not just us up there from Tightwad Hill. There are a couple other folks that we ran into over the course of the evening that either frequent the hill on a semi-regular basis or go on and up and on and you get the hit, go up on the hill on and off over the point of time. So it was always great to run into them. And as usually is the case with a Cal-related event, full-on pack night there. As you see, of course, they already had everything set up with Christmas-themed there with the holidays going on. So,
hey,
great night there. First time that I, you know, in my life that I've ever heard a Disney song played in a bar, by the way. They played that one song that King Louis sings during his scene of the Jungle Book. Never thought I'd hear a Disney song played in a bar, but hey, what do you expect with a dive bar?
Hey, well, look, it's the Kingfish and it's a cow bar to begin with. When someone was yours truly does not accept anything but cow fans for the most part, you have to at least represent cow. You will accept whatever day mama, and that's about it.
As always, of course, regardless of what ended up going down with the game over the course of the evening, shout out as always to the Kingfish, and thank you once again, by the way.
Always love you, baby.
Thank you all, of course, again, as always, for hosting us for our two previous watch parties. Might be a spot that is going to possibly be in the rotation for a hot minute when it comes to doing any sort of watch parties.
Forever.
For Cal Athletics in general going forward. All right. On that note, let's go ahead and get into recapping the actual game on the field that went down. The 47th edition of the Radiance Insurance Independence Bowl, rematch of a bowl game that, of course, played out back in 2004, by the way, when back in 2004, your California Golden Bears, of course, took on the Texas Tech Red Raiders. Same matchup going down in Shreveport, Louisiana last night. Looked like it was going to possibly maybe be easy sailing for the Golden Bears after the first quarter. They had a 14-7 lead after the first 15 minutes of this one. But pretty much from the second quarter out, it was a complete total disaster for the Golden Bears. They would not score anything.
All the way. They fucked it up all the way.
They would not score anything else after the first quarter, while the Texas Tech Red Raiders would go on to score 17 in the second quarter, 7 in the third quarter, and put up a field goal for their own amusement, I guess you could say, in the fourth and final quarter of the game, as the California Golden Bears unfortunately falling last night to the Texas Tech Raiders in the Independence Bowl by a final score of 34-14. Leading statistical leaders for Cal in this one, leading passer was Fernando Mendoza with 284 yards in the air. Jaden Ott only had 42 yards on the ground in this one. He did get a rushing touchdown, but pretty much got held the majority of the rest of the way out. And Tron Grizzled was the leading receiver for the Golden Bears with 83 receiving yards. Over on the Red Raiders side of things, Byron Morton was the leading passer with 256 yards in the air. Taj Brooks led their rushing attack with 99 rushing yards on the ground. And the leading receiver for Texas Tech was Corey Enkin with 106 receiving yards. Again, final score in the Radiance Insurance Independence Bowl, Texas Tech defeating Cal 34-14. Unfortunately, it was a great night still overall, but not the outcome that those of us that rep Bear territory wanted when it was all said and done.
All is left, and I'm going to save that part to the very end this time. I'm actually going to be prepared to let Keith do most of the shows, and I'm going to, you know what I do? I do what I do for what I real do, as I'm going to prosecute what I call prosecute this game for illegal football. Misrepresenting the Cal Bears, period. Let's go, boy.
And, man. And that pretty much is it on things with the Independence Bowl. And pretty much that wraps things up in 2023 for Cal football. The next time that, of course, you can catch the guys in action on the field will be when spring practices start up late March, early April. You, of course, will have the spring game going on at that point in time. And then, of course, next year is the opening year for your California Golden Bears, and not just football, but all the sports programs over in the ACC. And that, of course, wraps up things for this edition of the show for Cal Football. Our next edition of the broadcast, we, of course, will do an overall season and review recap of the Cal football program. Tad, anything else to add before we take our first break of the afternoon here on show number 39?
Prosecute this game because that's what the Cal Bears deserve. They didn't, for one, they squandered what we expected from the beginning. So just put their, what I, some of us call, put their dicks in a dirt away. I'm talking about the defensive side of the ball for the most part. But on the other side, the offense didn't pretty much help. There was too many, way too many turnovers as far as some of us feel. And for my final thought is, as far as I can't go too far, so even if I chose, Jesus is not going to let me do that. It's the fucking fact that they played illegal football, as some of us concerned. I'm pretty much done with this season because it didn't work out the way they work. And I appreciate the fact that they finally made it, and I was a part of that. And everybody knows that I love football to the point I even had a campaign of my own, which I called Six Sixes Campaign. I even took on a moniker that I was proud of because I was a sick motherfucker when I actually played football. And I was the only motherfucker who was able to seize football in a place I didn't even fuck around and play some football. I'm done with it. I ain't got it.
And that concludes this afternoon's thoughts on Cal football. On that note, let's go ahead and take our first break of the afternoon here on show number 39 of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill. We come back, we will check in on things over on the hardwood with the men's and women's basketball program. We'll start off things with the men's basketball program first, take our next show break, and of course then we'll check in on things with the women following that. Do not go anywhere, folks. We'll be right back at you here in a bit on show number 39 of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill. And welcome back, fellow Tightwads, fellow Cal football fans, fellow Cal athletics fans, and fellow A's fans tuning into the final TBR AFR doubleheader today here on twitch.tv/A's Fan Radio. 39th edition of a Cal fan produced podcast began back in November of 2020 that, of course, had its origins started in a segment over on our sister podcast. Of course, that being the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill. It's the tag team of the Govs coming at you today here on this edition of the show. Yours truly, of course, the 30th and current sitting governor of Tightwad Hill, Keith Salminen, and the 29th and previous sitting governor of Tightwad, Tad up here as well, who will be popping in here on and off over the course of the remainder of the show until we get to the baseball stuff at the end and our final thoughts before we head out on things. On that note, let's go ahead and head on over to the hardwood and see what the Cal men's basketball program has been up to since the last time we came at you here on the show. And, of course, what they have on tap between now and the next time we come at you here on the Bear Raid, which, of course, our next show will be on New Year's Eve when we come at you at 2 p.m. As I have a little Budweiser belch there mid-sentence. New Year's Eve show, on December the 31st at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. All righty, since last time we came at you here on the Bear Raid, Cal men's basketball has played in two matchups since last time we smacked you all upside the head back on December the 7th. First of those two matches was back on December the 9th in Indianapolis, Indiana, as the University of California Golden Bears, of course, took on Butler in a road matchup. Cal would outscore Butler 37-34 during the first half of the contest. Butler, though, would outscore the Golden Bears 39-36 to force overtime after the second quarter wrapped up. Both teams would each score 10 points in the first overtime period, so would have to take double OT to decide a winner in this one. Cal, unfortunately, ending up on the lopsided side of things in the second and final OT quarter, as Butler would outscore them in double the second overtime period, 14-7, and ultimately end up with the 97-90 victory over the men's basketball program in double OT. Leading scorers in this contest for the visiting California Golden Bears, you have Fardawaz Ahmed leading the scoring with a total of 24 points. He was 9 of 22 from the field, 2 of 3 from the three-point arc, and 4 of 5 from the three-point line. Other Cal Bears to score in double figures as well. You had Jalen Cohn score 23, Kenote Kennedy scoring 20, and Jalen Tyson chipping in 16 as well. Over on Butler's side of things, Posh Alexander led their scoring attack with 21 points. He was 9 of 16 from the field, 0 for 2 from the three-point arc, and 3 for 4 from the three-throw line. Other double-digit scores in this one for Butler, you had Jamal Telfort scoring 20 points, Pierre Brooks scoring 18 points, and DJ Tavis rounding out the Butler leading scores with a total of 13 points. Again, final score in this road matchup going down on December the 9th, your California Golden Bears falling to Butler by a final score of 97-90. Following that, the most recent matchup for the Cal men's basketball program going down yesterday, same day, of course, as the Independence Bowl down in Shreveport. The California Golden Bears has actually closed down windows I'm not supposed to be doing, playing at the Hall of Fame series in San Antonio, Texas, taking on the Ole Miss men's basketball program. Cal would get outscored 46-35 in the first half of this contest. They would outscore Ole Miss 43-42 in the second and final half of the game, though obviously when it's all said and done, all that matters at the end of things is the overall point total, as unfortunately, yet again, the California Golden Bears falling in a road matchup to Ole Miss this time on December the 16th by a final score of 88-78. Jalen Tyson leading the scoring attack for the Golden Bears in this one, 22 points total, 9 of 17 from the field, 1 of 5 from beyond the three-point arc, and he was a perfect 3 for 3 from the free throw line. Leading scorer for Ole Miss in this one was Jamin Breakerfield, who had 27 points for Ole Miss. He was 8 of 11 from the field, 5 of 7 from beyond the three-point arc, and he was 6 for 7 from the free throw line. Once again, Cal losing to Ole Miss in this contest by a final score of 88-78. Upcoming matchups for the Cal men's basketball program between now and show number 40 of the Bear Raid on December the 31st. They have three games slated to go down between now and then. And all three of those games, by the way, will be right back here in Berkeley, California at the Haas Pavilion. First of those three games will be a matchup on Wednesday, December the 20th. It's holiday celebration night at the Haas Pavilion, even though it's a 2 p.m. afternoon game, so I don't know why it doesn't say holiday celebration afternoon on there, but go figure, it's their giveaway. I guess they can decide what they want to ultimately call it. That, of course, so again, December the 20th, Haas Pavilion, 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for the tip-off in that one, as Cal will be hosting UC San Diego in that matchup on December the 20th. Friday, December the 29th, they will be playing a nightcap at the Haas Pavilion when Arizona comes into town. Again, 7:30 p.m. Arizona, December the 29th at the Haas Pavilion. And the final of those three games between now and the next show happens to go down on the same day as our next edition of the show. It, of course, will start 2 hours after we wrap up things here with the Bear Raid, or at some point after we wrap up things with the Bear Raid. So may have to obviously actually hold off on recapping that until the first show in the new year here on TBR. But Arizona State will come in to Berkeley on New Year's Eve for a 5 p.m. matchup at the Haas Pavilion. That, of course, wraps up this week's edition of Cal Men's Basketball Talk. Still got the ladies to check in on as well, obviously, to see what they've been up to and what they have on tap in the next 2 weeks. But we will find out what's going on with that after we take our next break of the afternoon. Hey, don't change that dial. Don't go and do anything unless you're going to have a quick little smoke or grab something out of the fridge. We will be right back at you here in a bit on show number 39 of the Bear Raid, presented by Tightwad Hill. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, all out there across the land and the globe that represent Bear Territory. Welcome back, of course, to show number 39 of the Bear Raid, presented by Tightwad Hill. Tag team of the Govs coming at you, of course, today, 30th and current sitting governor of Tightwad Hill, Keith Salminen, coming at you right here, right now. 29th and previous governor of Tightwad, Tad Dellinger III, of course, in studio as well. He'll be coming back on to join us during the final segment of this afternoon's broadcast. We touch bases on what's going on in the future, this upcoming 2024 with Cal Baseball, and obviously as well to share his final thoughts of the afternoon when we get ready to wrap up things here on this afternoon's edition of the Bear Raid. On that note, let's go ahead and touch bases on things with the final sport this afternoon that we'll be doing recent recaps and upcoming previews for. Obviously, we'll be looking at what is going on with Cal Baseball going into 2024 when we head into our upcoming final segment, but that doesn't get underway until February, so obviously we do need to touch bases on sports that are going down as of late and heading into when we, of course, do the next edition of the Bear Raid on New Year's Eve at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time here on Twitch. Final recent active sport we'll be covering, of course, this afternoon on the Bear Raid, of course, is the other basketball program at the University of California, the Lady Golden Bears, as co-host Donnie Knucklehead loves to call them. Let's check in right now on what Cal women's basketball has been up to since last time we came at you here on the show, and what they have on tap between now and the next edition of the Bear Raid on December the 31st. Three games going down for them since the last time we came at y'all here on the show. They actually had a game going down the same day as the last edition of the show. I want to say that since we did a night show, I think it was happening at basically the same time we were doing the Bear Raid, and by the time I had gotten into the Cal basketball portion on the previous show, this game hadn't wrapped up yet, so that's why we're recapping this game instead of having this week instead of having done it on the previous week's edition of the show. Matchup, of course, at the Haas Pavilion in Berkeley, California, on Pearl Harbor Remembrance Day between Cal and Gonzaga. California outscoring Gonzaga 17-13 in the first quarter, outscoring them as well 17-15 in the second quarter to close out things and head into the half with a lead. Unfortunately, though, Gonzaga would end up forcing overtime when it was all said and done. They would outscore Cal 20-13 in the third quarter. Cal would outscore them by a point in the fourth quarter, 18-17, to force a single overtime period on this night at the Haas. Ultimately, Gonzaga would outscore Cal 13-5 in the lone overtime period as Gonzaga gets the W in overtime against the Lady Golden Bears by a final score of 78-70. Leading scorer for Cal in this one was Marta Suarez, who had 19 points for the Lady Golden Bears. She was 7 of 16 from the field, 3 of 8 from beyond the three-point arc, and she was 2 for 4 from the free-throw line in this one. Leading scorer for the Bulldogs in this one was Giovanna Ejim, who had 21 points for the Lady Bulldogs of Gonzaga in this one. 9 of 19 from the field, didn't attempt any three-pointers in the contest, and she was 3 for 4 from beyond the three at the free-throw line. Excuse me. Again, Cal falling to Gonzaga in this contest on December the 7th at the Haas Pavilion by a final score of 70-80. I just actually realized I forgot to go over the men's basketball record during the previous segment, so obviously I got to make sure to remember to discuss the women's record when I wrap things up here with the Lady Golden Bears here in a bit. So a little side note for me to remember that. So my apologies for forgetting to mention the men's current record. Gotcha. Obviously remember to do that when we do the men's show segment on the next edition of the show. But yeah, remember, Keith, do that when you wrap up things here with the Lady Golden Bears segment. All right, let's continue on recapping those three games for the Lady Golden Bears that went down between the last time we came at you and, of course, what's going to be on tap for them the next time we came at you. After that loss to Gonzaga, the Lady Golden Bears would play a home game 2 nights later on December the 9th at the Haas Pavilion as the University of Nevada would come into town. Cal would outscore them 20-6 in the first quarter and also outscore them 16-15 to close out things at the half in the second quarter. The outscoring would continue pretty much the rest of the way out in the second half as Cal would outscore Nevada 24-13 in the third quarter and outscore them 16-15 in the fourth and final quarter to ultimately net a 79-49 win on their home court in Berkeley. Again, 79-49, Lady Golden Bears with a victory in this matchup. Leading scorer for California was Michaela Williams, who scored 20 points in the contest. She was 7 of 8 from the field, 4 of 5 from beyond the three-point arc, and she was 2 for 3 from the free-throw line in this one. Over on the Wolfpack side of things, Aubrey Roden was their leading scorer with 9 points. She was 4 of 9 from the field, 1 of 3 from beyond the three-point arc, and did not attempt any free throws in the contest. Again, final score in this December 9th contest at the Haas Pavilion in Berkeley, Lady Golden Bears defeating Nevada 76-49. That, of course, brings us to the most recent game for the Lady Golden Bears basketball program, which went down 2 days ago. Another home game at the Haas Pavilion. Lady Golden Bears getting to enjoy some home cooking and home warmth here these last couple of weeks over the course of doing things. Lady Golden Bears hosting Eastern Washington in a matchup that went down at the Haas back on December the 15th. Cal outscoring them 23-20 in the first quarter. They got outscored 18-10 by Eastern Washington in the second quarter of that contest. Eastern Washington would outscore them again 21-13 in the third quarter, but then Cal would basically blow them out to seize and take the W when it was all said and done with a 32-11 fourth quarter to ultimately get a 78-70 victory in Berkeley on December the 15th. Leading scorer for the Lady Golden Bears, Marta Suarez, with 17 points for the Cal Golden Bears. She was 5 of 14 from the field, 1 for 5 from the three-point arc, and a perfect 6 for 6 from the free-throw line in this one. Over on the Eastern Washington side of things, Jacita Buckley was their leading scorer with 16 points. She was 6 of 12 from the field, 4 of 8 from beyond the three-point arc, and she did not attempt any free throws in that contest. Again, final score at the Haas Pavilion on December the 15th, Cal getting the victory over Eastern Washington by a final score of 78-70. Upcoming matchups for the Lady Golden Bears between now and the next time we come at you here on the Bear Raid on December the 31st. Two games going down for the Lady Golden Bears basketball program. That, of course, will be two games that, of course, will all take place in Berkeley. So the home cooking continues for the Lady Golden Bears basketball program. The first of those two games going down on Thursday, December the 21st. That, of course, is the holiday game in Berkeley this year, as Louisiana Monroe will come in for an afternoon tip-off at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time at the Haas Pavilion in Berkeley. Again, that, of course, is on December the 21st, which is a Thursday. Louisiana Monroe against Cal at the Haas Pavilion at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And then 2 days before our next edition of the Bear Raid, you will have the Battle of the Bay throwdown between the Lady Golden Bears and the Lady Ferd, as, of course, the University of Stanford will be coming to Berkeley for a 2 p.m. tip-off on December the 29th. Now, since I forgot to do it for the men's program, I went ahead and scrolled back up real quickly so I remember to do it this time. Current standings at this point in time for the Cal women's basketball program are as follows. They're 9-2 overall. They have yet to play a conference game. Of course, obviously, that will change once they play Stanford between now and the next time we come at you. They're on a 2-game win streak at this point in time. They're 7-2 so far this season at the Haas Pavilion, and they're undefeated away from the Haas so far this season with a record of 2-0. So Lady Golden Bears program continuing to dominate for the most part. Men obviously started off struggling. They've been starting to look a little bit better as of late, but still obviously a lot of road for improvement on the men's side of things. That wraps up the Lady Golden Bears basketball talk. That, of course, wraps up as well basketball talk for this edition of the show and recent activities as far as active sports right now at the University of California, which means, hey, Final break time here on show number 39 of the Bear Raid. We come back, we'll go ahead and take a look at the upcoming 2024 schedule for the Cal baseball program, and of course, mine and Tad's final thoughts before we check on out. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back at you here in a bit on show number 39 of the Bear Raid, presented by Tightwad Hill. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back as we get ready to wrap things up here on the first of two shows going down today on this Twitch channel. Final segment coming at you right here, right now, on show number 39 of the Bear Raid, presented by Tightwad Hill. 30th and current sitting governor of Tightwad, Keith Salminen, and the 29th and previous governor of Tightwad, Tad Dellinger III, coming at you, of course, from Dub 6 Studios, located in the Diamond District of Oakland, California. Got, of course, done just talking about things with the basketball programs, touch bases on things with Cal football earlier in the broadcast, of course. And before we, of course, get on into our final thoughts of the afternoon, before we sit back and relax and get ready for the final edition of A's Fan Radio in the coming hours, one thing we wanted to touch bases on before we got on out of here, of course, is potentially, again, unless the Oakland Ballers come hollering at me, might be the only baseball yours truly talks about in the foreseeable future, as the Cal men's the Cal baseball program, of course, putting out their schedule for 2024 since the last time we came at you here on the show. Upcoming games for the men's basketball program are slated as follows. They, of course, will be partaking in the MLB Desert Invitational, where they will face off against Kansas State on February 16th. They will take on Georgetown on February the 17th. They will take on Boston College in the final game of that Invitational tournament on February the 18th. After that, they will face Brigham Young in Berkeley on February the 21st. They will host Connecticut in Berkeley on February the 23rd. And that, of course, will be a three-game series that will run from February the 23rd through the 25th at Evans Diamond in Berkeley. Sacramento State will then come in for a quick little one-game contest on February the 25th. They will then head out to the punk-ass desert that is Las Vegas for the Las Vegas College Baseball Classic, where they will take on Ohio State on March 1st. They will take on Oklahoma on March the 2nd, and their final game of that tournament will be on March the 3rd against Pittsburgh. After that, they will take on Stanford in a quick little one-game throwdown in Berkeley on March the 5th, and then begin a three-game series in Berkeley against UCLA from March 8th through March the 10th. Three-game series then up in Eugene, Oregon, against the Ducks from March 15th through the 17th. One-game throwdown on March 19th against the University of San Francisco in San Francisco, California. Utah will then come into Berkeley for a three-game matchup that will go down from March 22nd through March the 24th. One-game throwdown against Santa Clara on Monday, March the 25th, followed by a three-game series against Arizona State in Phoenix that will take place from March 28th through March the 30th. One-game matchup against Pacific that will go down on Tuesday, April the 7th at Evans Diamond in Berkeley, that, of course, will be followed by a three-game matchup in Berkeley against the University of Arizona that will go down from April 5th through April the 7th. Two-game series after that against St. Mary's, technically a 1-1, you can say, as April the 9th, they will play a game in Berkeley, and then the second game of that two-game series will head out to Moraga and take on St. Mary's in a road game on April the 10th. After that, they have a three-game series in Pullman against Washington State that will play out from April the 12th through April the 14th. One-game throwdown at Evans Diamond against USF on April the 16th. Three-game series against Oregon State that will go down from April April 19th through the 21st. One game throwdown against Pacific on April the 23rd before they play a three-game set at the Sunken Diamond in Stanford against Stanford. That will go down the 26th through the 28th of April. Three-game series in L.A. against USC on May the 3rd through May the 5th. Three-game series against San Jose State that will take place in Berkeley May 10th through May the 12th. One game against Stanford on May the 13th. And then their final three games of the year will be at home against Washington. And that will go down May 16th through May the 18th. Taddy, any thoughts you got on Cal baseball going into 2024?
Okay, I do have this. We're going to actually, as I call it, fuck with it, all right, this year, live, okay, and try to figure, I'm going to probably appreciate what I was supposed to appreciate anyway, because I do have some passion for baseball. I haven't owned up to that part. We're going to own up to that part as well.
Definitely expect to
see me
catch
out fucking regular basis. Yeah. Comment on the fucking week. Yeah.
Definitely expect to see our faces out there a little bit more often at Cal baseball games, especially me. Of course, that could change if I'm, you know, well, nah, I'll have the time frame to do that if I were working with the Ballers, because the Ballers don't start up
until after Cal baseball gets done.
But yeah, definitely expect to catch Tightwad invading Cal baseball at various points in the upcoming season.
You know me anyway.
Well, I'm pretty sure basically we can pretty much plan out which games to go to whenever we're here getting ready to do stuff for our shows. So yeah, definitely look to catch us out there. And for the rest of y'all out there, be sure to make way out to either Evans Diamond, or if you happen to live out in the various areas where the Golden Bears baseball program will be playing as road teams in the upcoming year, be sure to go out and support your Cal baseball program as well. That wraps up things for the sports talk here on today's edition of the show. Let's go ahead and get on out of here with our final thoughts of the afternoon. Leading off our final thoughts, of course, is 29th Governor of Tightwad, Tad.
And here we go. For this season, I'm going to say farewell to Cal football, period. I'll catch you guys, everyone who enjoys, has passion for the game at our, hopefully to be the best spring football practice, the end of practice. You won't see me actually mess with any practice, period, until the spring game. This year I'm planning for it to be even better than what we've had so far. And on, I ready to go with that. And expect to see us more of the other Cal events as well. That's a free line. I'm ready to go.
That's right. I did forget to mention, by the way, we've also talked about showing our faces up a little bit more at some Cal baseball or Cal basketball games, excuse me, as well. So keep your eyes open for us all at other Cal events. Taddy, you got something else?
Yes, of course. And 24, I'm going to say this. We know that they're always going to suck somehow. There's always that period of suckage that's going to continue. We are not able to prevent that period. And I'm ready to own up to that. Both of us are. So we're going to appreciate what the Bears finally give us, and there will be no more campaigns. I want this campaign capping down, because I thought at least give us this much satisfaction, okay, at least once in a while. Give us some good football once in a while, not punk-ass football, the way you feel like playing it, Justin, because I'm really accept you as long as we pay the players. That's all I'm accepting, because that's legal now, by the way. I'm getting ready to get out of here.
Taddy, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. Hopefully we will catch you again here on a future edition of the show. Of course, as always, for latest information pertaining to the Bear Raid and Tightwad Hill in general, be sure to check things out at facebook.com/Tightwad Hill Official. Follow the Madness over on Twitter at Tightwad Hill 23. Check out things on our temporary page on A's Fan Radio's website at aesfanradio.com/The Bear Raid, presented by Tightwad Hill. Live shows you can always, of course, catch here on what for now is still twitch.tv/AceFanRadio. Again, a rebrand's coming for that, though, in the new year. Same thing goes for the YouTube channel, but for the time being, obviously, the YouTube channel is still called youtube.com/AceFanRadio, and that's, of course, where you can catch all of our past editions of the show and more. And, of course, show number 40 will hit you all upside the heads on New Year's Eve in the afternoon. Not at night. It'll be in the afternoon on New Year's Eve, 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on December the 31st for our 40th edition of TBR. On that note, once again, thanks to the hosts and owners of the Kingfish for allowing Tightwad Hill to once again come and watch a game, an event from their establishment. Again, hey, not the outcome the Bear territory wanted, but hey, I still had fun there last night. I've always had fun going to watch sporting events at the Kingfish, and definitely looking forward to tapping in and doing some stuff there maybe more often for not just Cal football, but for other Cal athletics games as far as road watch party goes. Again, hey, wasn't the season we all originally were expecting. I'm pretty sure we all had higher hopes when it came to things with Cal football in 2023. But those of you, of course, that are lifelong fans of the football program or have known family that have followed the football program for longer than you've been alive, some of y'all out there probably have someone like my late grandmother that during the Tedford era warned me, hey, enjoy this success while it lasts, because since the 1950s, Cal football usually is good for 10 years and then sporadically sucks for 2 to 3 decades with some little bit of success here and there. You know, hey, could have been better, is what it is, but definitely some room there for improvement in 2024, and it's going to obviously gonna be interesting to see what is done to make those improvements in 2024, especially with us getting ready to debut in a whole new conference next year. As of course, 2024 marks our first year for not just the football program, but all the athletic programs in the ACC, starting with the 24-25 academic year. On that note, on behalf of myself, Taddy, Donnie, and Tito, who unfortunately, again, because of prior commitments, cannot make it tonight, on behalf of the cast here at the Bear Raid, thank you all, as always, for tuning in. Take care. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon. And, of course, be sure to tune in for the second half of today's doubleheader broadcast when A's Fan Radio, of course, goes down at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. The views and opinions of our cast, our guests, and our listeners are in no way, shape, or form affiliated with the University of California, Cal Athletics, the Pac-12 Conference, our future home in the ACC, or the NCAA. Thank you all again for tuning in. Reminder again, be sure to catch the second half of today's doubleheader broadcast, the final edition of A's Fan Radio, going down at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And, of course, be sure to catch our next broadcast when it hits you all beside the head on New Year's Eve at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on December the 31st. Thank you all again for tuning in. Take care. Stay safe out there. Stay blue. Stay gold. And, of course, as always, roll on, you Bears! Thank you all again for tuning in. We will see you at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on December the 31st for the next edition of TBR.